Sorry?
Training?
Yeah.
Head down. Have you done this one a while?
No, I've not.
So you feel when you haven't done it for a while, how can you weaken that top hand?
Yeah.
Well, you can always maintain it. Even though it's a boring drill, but it's being more of a maintenance one. You have to do it actually. And once you get it, then you can leave for a week. I think you have to do it all the time. Get it to where you, you know, when you've done it good, right? Remember when you get back to there, you know, cool, top hand strong. Good hand. That's your fastball hand.
Yeah.
Good. Once you got it, so you feel like you got it there?
Yeah.
All right, then you switch to the other hand, make sure you got that one. So take this one, just... So this one's to make you feel comfortable without anything outside in the load.
Mm-hmm.
So then you know you got it, like, your mechanics for both when you go back to two hands. So once you get that, you're like, all right, cool, I can handle the fastball up and in. Cool, I can handle the fastball on the way, then you go, then you're comfortable to go to two hands. And it makes it comfortable during the game. Get it at your knees. There you go. Turn. There you go. Drop the head. There you go. Good. Nice. Drop the head. Boom. Not bad. Put the other arm in. And we'll go back to sit. We'll go to two hands. Yeah, take this up. Take this up. Well, soon.
Yeah.
This up. Good. Good. More power and bat speed. Like that. Try hit it better. That's the last one. Same again, get a good hit. Don't try and do too much next to bat. Do the same thing.
Yeah.
There you go. And do the same thing. Boy, just tough pitch right there. Crushed it. Nice. Good. Nice. There you go. So these will be more away. See how it's easy to reach with one hand?
Yeah.
Oh. You should always try and use that one hand release. That's where you get more power.
Yeah.
Except for up and in. Then you just react on the two hands.
Yeah.
Looking for something to get extended on, I guess, more to that way is where you're going to get most hits with that one hand release. And then with two strikes, don't think, if they come up and in on you, you would actually use that two hand follow through.
Yeah.
You're going to get more power with that one hand. It's just something at your knees, middle away. Just trying to get it the other way. That's where you're going to get your most power from.
Yeah.
See? And less effort. There you go, perfect. My multi-swing method. That's one of the first people to master. So you just came in, it was a natural two-hand swing.
Yeah.
So you're kind of thinking, top hand release, but came up and in, you use that two-hand follow through to turn off.
Yeah.
So we're training that two-hand one, we're training it when you're not thinking, we're kind of thinking to react. Otherwise, you're kind of looking for that, looking away, reacting, hoping. We're training how to do that. Woo!